Okay, good morning, everyone. I will take over here from Hans and taking the perspective of what can we do with biochemical conversion methods in this concept of biorefineries. So basically using microorganisms and enzymes offer a possibilities of process steps in biorefinery concept where we work with very specific conversion technologies. We work at ambient temperatures and pH, and we all also avoid harsh chemicals in these process steps. To take you back to the biorefinery process, what you see here is just a simplification from the point of view where we can use the enzymes and the microorganisms. So after a pre-treated raw material stream, if we want to access the sugars that is present in hemicellulose and in lignin, if they have not been released, we can use enzymes and enzymatic hydrolysis to release the sugar units, and in this fermentable sugar stream, we then use microorganisms to convert the sugars to a targeted product. This could be energy carriers as ethanol, butanol, or more advanced biofuels, but it can also be different kind of chemicals, platform chemicals that can be further converted to interesting materials. In order to do this, we need enzymes and we need microorganisms that are suited to this kind of processes that we have in the biorefineries. And one of the challenges is that we have inhibitors that comes from the pretreatment that influence negatively enzymes and microorganisms. So we have to develop the enzymes and the microorganisms. And that is one of the key missions we have in my research group. And in order to have the enzymes and the microorganisms to do a good job, we need to have robust microorganisms and processes. So basically, when we put them in an industrial biorefinery stream, we would like to press the outcome to high yields and productivities. But due to that these streams are quite harsh, we will have some challenges when it comes to robustness. So that is another important research theme that we work on, where we develop both the process to, so that they are robust, and also the enzymes and the microorganisms. And one definition that one can have for robustness is the ability to maintain performance in the face of perturbations and uncertainty. So this is inherent properties in living systems, but if we press them too much, they cannot live up to this. So one component we use in biochemical conversions is enzymes. And Hans before talked a little bit about the complex structure. This is another illustration of how the structure of biomass looks like. Depending on the source, it would look different. But the point here from the enzymatic point of view is that the enzymes can cut specific bonds in this complex structure of solid material and therefore help us doing the work that we are targeting. And as one kind of enzymes can cut one kind of bonds, we would typically need many different enzymes if we want to completely hydrolyze the material to release the sugars. When it comes to developing biorefinery processes, we would like to work in streams where we have a high biomass content, a high substrate concentration. This is a pretreated spruce material at 30% water-insoluble solids. If you compare this to a 30% sugar solution, this has a different character. So one of our focus is to find out how we could efficiently convert such a raw material. There is a number of challenges that has to be addressed. The stream we have after pretreatment, it's there we have issues around mass transfer, mixing, inhomogeneity and viscosity in order to drive these processes. When it comes to the enzymatic hydrolysis, we end up with high sugar levels that is inhibitory to the enzymes, and we have the high levels of the inhibitory compounds that also address a challenge for us. And when it comes to the fermentation step, we, in addition to what I already mentioned, we also have nutrient deficiency and high product concentrations that also could be a challenge to the microorganism. So we have addressed these different issues in different ways to try to come up with solutions, and I will present one aspect of improving the process robustness. And this is a concept where we use multi-feed, simultaneous saccharification and co-fermentation process. Basically, we take the pre-treated raw material, feed solids, feed enzymes into the fermentation process, and also have a continuous feed of the yeast, in this case, for ethanol production. And by doing this, we can circumvent some of the issues I described before. A key here is the continuous yeast cultivation, as yeast it has a limited viability in this kind of processes. So here is just to illustrate that the success of such an approach. When we started the project, we have almost no fermentation. We had only an ethanol yield of 13% of the theoretical one, using 20% water-insoluble spruce. And by applying this in the first instance, this process, the ethanol yield went up to 56%. And we circumvented some of the issues we had with inhibition of hydrolysis and fermentation and with mixing. This approach has been taken further. I will not tell you anything about the details, but different approaches, you can see how we have increased the maximal ethanol titer further and getting closer to the theoretical yield. So here, there is a lot I want to... The message here is we can do a lot by developing the process strategy, and the key here has been the cell viability. The next part is the microorganism as such that is responsible for the conversion. By using metabolic engineering, we can then work with the metabolic network and produce targeted compounds. So we, in principle, we develop a cell factory producing compounds we target. We have some different examples we have worked with of products. And in addition, one of our main focus is then also to develop the microorganism, understanding the microbial traits that is responsible for robustness in the microorganism. So if we look at what these conditions can do to the microorganism, this is just a overview of all the different molecular events that happens as a response to inhibitory compounds present in the biorefinery streams. This is an example of the effects of acidic acid. Basically, the message here is that there are a lot of effects that these inhibitors make on the microorganism. So what we have done is to develop a strategy how we can work with cellular robustness in order to circumvent these drastic effects, so increasing the cellular robustness. And there are some different principles we can work with. So if these inhibitors does not reach the cells, the intracellularly, they will not have any action. So we can reduce the uptake or help the cells to get rid of this compound. Another strategy that we can use is when the cells are influenced by these compounds, there are some damage. So we can help the cells by supplying them with mechanisms to reduce the damage or mechanisms to enhance the repair. And the finally approach that we can do is that we can help the cells to intracellularly convert compounds that are toxic to them. So basically, this is a portfolio of possibilities where we principles we can use to improve cell performance. And just a short example, this is from a where we have worked with glutathione metabolism in the yeast cells. And the result is that we could get a 70% increase of ethanol production from a lignocellulosic stream. And there are many other examples like this. So to conclude, I would like to say that biochemical conversion processes offers a lot of possibilities in the biorefinery concept. I haven't talked about anaerobic digestion and bioelectrical systems, but these are also microbial processes where we can bring value to diluted process streams. One of the keys in order to be successful is then to have robust processes and cells. And that I would like to close with thanking my the members in the Industrial Biotechnology Group that directly or indirectly have contributed to what I talked about. Thank you.